This monitor is great. I love everything about it, but sometimes I don't want to play my games like this. Sometimes I want the game centered in the middle with something like Spotify on the left, Discord on the right, or whatever. I had some trouble setting this up, but I found a way and I wanted to share that with anybody who might be having a similar issue. This is how I used to do this. I used to just play in windowed mode with the bar at the top, but it wasn't perfect because I had the annoying bar up there and then down at the bottom it didn't fit. So I'll show you how I use an application. I push a key on the keyboard and it snaps everything into place. The way I do this is through a program called DisplayFusion. I'm just a regular dude, I'm not in any way sponsored, it's just what I found that works for me. I'm pretty sure you can try to do this with something like Fancy Zones and a couple other programs. I played around, I wasn't able to get it working great, so I ended up using DisplayFusion. I am pretty sure that you need the pro version to get this working, so keep that in mind, but just play around and give it a shot. Once you have it up and running, you're going to want to right-click on it into the taskbar and head to Monitor Configuration, and you'll get a screen that looks like this. Once you're in here, click on Splits and Padding to pop this open. This is where we set up basically the virtual monitors within the one monitor. So I've got 1.1, 1.2, and 1.3. 1.2 is the main 2560 by 1440. That's basically a 1440p gaming monitor. And then I've got two over on the side. If you have the same monitor, just use these values. The only thing to keep in mind is that for 1.1, you'll have a left axis of 0. For 1.2, you'll have to indent 1280. And for 1.3, 3840. Get it nice and set up, hit OK, and then you're done in this section for now. Next, we're going to go into Settings. So right-click and head to Settings. You'll get something that looks like this. Go to Functions over on the left, and then pop open a scripted function and hit Download. This will pop up a list where you can search for the word borders. And you'll see one highlighted green here because I have it. This is the one we want. It's called Remove Borders, Size to Full Screen, Make Borderless Windowed by these people. Shout out to them. Just click on that and hit Download Function, and then it'll add it to your list of functions available to you. Afterwards, you can double click on it. It'll pop it open. And you're going to want to set a key combination. This is going to be the combo that you push to get the game to snap into the right position. So pick something that works for you. I went with Control-Alt-F. That way I didn't accidentally push it. And F meant fix to me. Just pick whatever you like and then get this saved. Hit OK. And make sure everything looks good like this. The final step is to click Advanced Settings down here at the bottom, and then filter for the word split. You'll get one result, Windows Taskbar Split Monitor ID. The number that you put in here, for me it's 1.1, it chooses which split your Windows Taskbar is gonna show up on. So for me that's only on the far left. It doesn't interfere with the game in the middle at all, so I went with 1.1. Just double click on it, type in the value you want, and hit OK and get it saved. At this point you're done, but I got a couple tips to leave you with. First, when you start a game, don't use full screen mode, it just isn't going to work. Most of the time what I shoot for is windowed mode at 1440p, and then I use the hotkey to make it not actually windowed. I have had this work with borderless as well, so something like Cyberpunk and Red Dead just works great there, you're just going to have to play around. Second, this isn't going to work on every single game. Most of them do play nicely, I would say over 90% of them do, but not all of them work. Something like Guild Wars 2 and Diablo 4, for some reason, they're just real sticklers about it, and in those situations, I just wasn't able to get it working how I wanted it to. Third, a little trick I found, sometimes you actually have to push your hotkey a couple of times. I've had it where it looks like it fits, but things are just slightly blurry and a little bit off. Pushing the hotkey once or twice again fixes it. And if you have any questions, just shoot me a message on Discord, I'll drop my name below. I'm happy to help if I can, because I honestly can't imagine using this monitor any other way.